Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. In 2012, I did a tutorial showing how to make a subject pop out of its photo, creating a 3D effect. Due to its popularity, we'll take it one step further by creating the look of a 3D pop-out style card. Open a photo you'd like to use. It's best if the subject is centered and in the foreground. Keep in mind, since every photograph is different, the results can and will vary. The size of this document is 1500 by 1000 pixels and a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. Press Ctrl or Command A to select the entire photo, and then go to Select and Save Selection. Click OK to save it. We need to make a selection around the subjects so we can cut them out from their background. For this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool with a radius of 10 pixels. Click and drag over your subjects. To remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt on a PC or Option on a Mac and drag over those areas. Once you have your selection, press Q on your keyboard to make it into a quick mask. If you need to retouch any areas, just use your brush tool. Press Q again to make it back into a selection. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut the subjects from their background and copy them to their own layer. Go to Image and Canvas Size. Change the inches to percent and make the width and the height 130% each. Make the canvas extension any color you'd like and click OK. To fit the entire document on your screen, press Ctrl or Command 0. Make your background active. Open your Channels panel, go to Alpha 1, and Ctrl-click it on a PC or Command-click it on a Mac. This makes the channel into a selection. Open back up your Layers panel and press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the photo. Make the background active again and open your Gradient tool. Click on the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Click on the third box, which is the black to white gradient. Then click OK. Go to the middle of your photo and press and hold Shift as you drag down to the bottom of your document. Then release. Next, we need to retouch the background and remove the subjects from it. We'll use Content Aware Fill. But first, make Layer 2 active, go to Layer 1, and Control or Command click it to make a selection of its shape. Click off the eyeball of Layer 1 to hide it. Go to Select, Modify, and Expand. For this example, I'll expand it by 2 pixels. For your photo, you may want to experiment with different amounts. Go to Edit, Fill, and Content Aware. Instantly, Content Aware fills the selection with your background. To delete the selection, press Ctrl or Command D. Content Aware Fill isn't perfect, but it does do most of the heavy lifting. Keep in mind, your subjects will ultimately cover most of this area after we angle and fold the card. However, I would like to retouch some of the glaring inconsistencies, so I'll use my Clone Stamp tool. I covered how to use the stamp tool in many of my tutorials. Next, we'll create a white border. Click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll name it Border. Go to Layer 2 and press Ctrl or Command to make a selection of its shape. Go to Edit and Stroke. Make the width 20 pixels and the color is white. Delete the selection and press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. Go to a bottom corner and press and hold Ctrl Shift Alt on a PC or Command Shift Option on a Mac and drag it out until the corners are fairly close to the edges of your document. Go to a top corner and using the same keystrokes, drag it in. Go to the top middle point and press and hold Shift as you drag it down. Then press Enter or Return. Next, we'll hide the image that's outside the border and use Content Aware Fill to fill in the empty areas inside the border. Control-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of the border to make a selection of its shape, and press Q to make it into a quick mask. Open your Paint Bucket tool and invert the foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard or by clicking on the small double box icon. Click outside the border to delete the quick mask, leaving just the inside intact. Press Q again to make the quick mask back into a selection, and invert it by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. Make your card active, and click on the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the card. Next, we'll fill in the corners. Make your card active and open your Rectangular Marquee tool. Draw a rectangle over the empty area and go to Edit and Fill. Fill it with Content Aware and delete the selection. Repeat the steps to fill in the right corner. Click off the eyeball of the background to hide the layer. Make a composite snapshot of your image, which we'll place above the border. Make the border layer active and press Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on a PC or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Now that we have the composite snapshot, we can trash the layers that comprised it. Make your background visible, go to View, and make sure Rulers and Snap are checked. If they're not, just click on them. Open your Transform tool, go to the left ruler, and drag out a guideline to the center. It'll snap in place because we have Snap checked. If you don't see your guideline, press Ctrl or Command H. Press Enter or Return. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag out a rectangle across the left half of your document. Cut the left half of the card and copy it to its own layer. Make the full card active and drag a rectangle across the right half of your document. Cut and copy the right half and hide the full card. Next, we'll skew up both sides of the card to make it look like it's been folded and then opened. Open your Transform tool, go to the middle right, and press and hold Ctrl or Command plus Shift and drag it up to an angle you like. Then press Enter or Return. Go to the top ruler and drag down a guideline until it snaps to the top corner of the card. Make the left half active. Open your Transform tool, use the same keystrokes as before, and drag it up until the top corner touches the guideline. Then press Enter or Return and hide the guidelines. We're going to make the left page slightly darker and then add a soft shadow under the entire card. Click on the adjustment layer icon and choose Levels. Click on the Clip to Layer icon to restrict the adjustment layer to affect only the one layer beneath it. In the right output level box, type in 220. Control-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of the full card to make a selection of its shape. Make the layer active and make a new layer above it. We'll name it Shadow. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 10 pixels. We'll fill it with black, and since black is the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Then delete the selection. Reduce the shadow's opacity to 30%. Since shadows tend to be a bit darker the closer they are to the subject, We'll make a copy of the shadow and click on the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the copy. Open your brush tool, increase the size to 1000 pixels, and keep the hardness at 0%. Brush once over the outer halves of the shadow. Make your subject visible and active. Open your Move tool and drag your subject up to a position where its base fits naturally on the background. Next, we'll cast the shadows of the subjects onto the card. Make a selection of its shape and make a new layer below it by control clicking or command clicking on the new layer icon. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 10 pixels. Fill it with black and delete the selection. Change the blend mode to multiply and decrease the opacity to 30%. Then press Enter or Return. Make the guidelines visible and open your Rectangular Marquee tool. Drag a rectangle across the left half of your document and cut and copy the left half. Make the full shadow active and drag a rectangle across the right half. Cut and copy the right half and hide the guidelines. Open your Transform tool, go to the top middle, press Ctrl or Command plus Shift and drag it to the right. Go to the bottom middle and using the same keystrokes, drag it to the left so the shadow is directly under your subject. Then press Enter or Return. Make the left shadow active and repeat the steps. The last step is to make the top of your subject a bit brighter to make it look like it's reflecting light off its surface. Make the subject active and make a selection of its shape. Make a layer mask of the selection and make the subject active again. Open your brush tool and make the size 400 pixels. Make the blend mode linear dodge and the opacity 10%. Then press Enter or Return. Invert the foreground and background colors. Brush once over the top of your subject at a downward angle. Have fun transforming one of your photos into a 3D pop-out card. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.